Miles to go class. Today I, Shivani, your science teacher, again here to tell you about the topic weather, climate and adaptations. Are you excited? Let's come.
Today we are going to learn about weather, climate and adaptations. The day-to-day change or condition of the atmosphere is called weather. The weather changes from day to day and can even change several times in one day. All weather changes are caused due to the sun. The weather is hot when the sun shines brightly. The weather is cool when the sun is covered with clouds. Let's discuss about the elements of weather. First is temperature. Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body or place. The maximum temperature of day generally occurs at the noon time, while the minimum temperature occurs at early morning. A maximum and minimum thermometer is used to record the maximum and minimum temperature of the day. Humidity. Humidity, the amount of water vapor present in the air at a given temperature is called humidity. Relative humidity is the measure of amount of water vapor present in the air at a specific temperature. Compared to the maximum water vapor, the air can hold at the temperature and thus it is represented in terms of percentages. Now, the relative humidity depends on temperature, so its value keeps changing in a day. Humidity is measured with the help of an instrument, that is hygrometer. Now, let's discuss about the rainfall. It occurs when there is high humidity in the air and there is a sudden drop in the temperature. When clouds become very heavy, they burst and fall down as rain. Rain gauge is an instrument which is used to measure rainfall. Rainfall is measured in millimeters. Now let's discuss about climate. The average weather pattern at a place taken over a long period of time, say 25 years, is called the climate of that place. The climate of a place is determined by its latitude. Based on the difference in climate, there are three temperate zones in the world. First is torrid zone, second is temperate zone, and the third one is frigid zone. Torrid zone. It is also known as the tropics. The sun is directly overhead at least once during the year. The torrid zone forms the hottest region of the world with two annual seasons, a dry and a wet season. The desert region have dry climate, whereas the Sahara Desert is the hottest desert in the world. And the tropical regions are located near the equator and have hot climate with plenty of rainfall. The second one is temperate zone. In this region, the sun is never directly overhead and the climate is mild, generally ranging from warm to cool. The four annual seasons, spring, summer, autumn and winter, occur in these areas. The North Temperate Zone includes Great Britain, Europe, Northern Asia, North America and Northern Mexico. Now the last one is Frigid Zone. It is the coldest part of the earth. They are generally covered with ice and snow. The North Frigid Zone includes the northern part of the Canada, Alaska, Greenland and Russia, and the Arctic in between them. The South Frigid Zone consists of the continent of Antarctica. The factors that determine the climate of the place are as follows: distance from the equator, wind direction, temperature, rainfall and humidity. Distance from the sea, places near the sea have moderate climate, and the last one, height above the sea level, and the higher you go, the cooler it becomes. Now let's move to the adaptations of animals. The features or characteristics of an organism which enables it to survive and breed in its habitat are called adaptations. Adaptations to live in polar region. Animals like polar bear, penguin, foxes, birds, seals and whales are found in the polar region. Adaptation in polar bear. It has two layers of fur that protect it from the extreme cold. A thick layer of fat called blubber under the skin insulates the body from the cold. It has the ability to close its nostrils, which helps it to stay under the water for a long period of time. It has a strong sense of smell that enables it to locate and catch its prey. It has short ears and tails, and it has long, curved, sharp claws that provide good grip and helps it to walk on ice. Adaptations in penguins. Penguins are flightless birds found in the polar regions. They have the following adaptations, that is, their white colors at bottom merges with the white snow. The black color feathers absorb heat from the sun and keep them warm. The thick skin and the thick layer of fat underneath keep them warm in the extreme cold climate. The body is streamlined and feet have webs, enabling them to swim. The ears are very small, which prevent heat loss from the body. Next is migration, the mass movement of a bird to escape from harsh weather in search of food or for breeding purposes is called migration.
The Siberian cranes comes to India from Siberia every year for a few months and fly back to Siberia when winters and there and the climate becomes favorable.
Now, adaptations to live in tropical regions. So before starting with this, we just take example, that is adaptations of a camel. It has a hump that stores fat. It has big eyelashes that prevents sand from entering the eyes during sandstorm. It is thick lips that helps it to eat prickly plants like cacti. Now let's discuss about the adaptation in elephants. Elephants have big trunks which they use as a nose and to pick up the food. They use their trunk for drinking water. They use their tusk to tear the bark of trees and for fighting purposes. They use their large ears to hear very soft sounds, enabling them to sense danger and to run away. They flap their long ears to cool themselves in the hot and humid climate. Now let's discuss about the adaptation in lions and tigers. The body colors of the lions and tigers merges with the surrounding. This helps them to camouflage and also helps them to catch their prey. They have sharp eyesight that enables them to locate the prey from a distance. They have a sharp sense of smell that also helps them to locate their prey. They can run very fast, which helps them to catch their prey. Now, adaptation in red-eyed frog. It has sticky pads on its feet and that help it to climb trees on which it lives. During daytime, they camouflage themselves by remaining motionless, shutting their eyes and squeezing in their feet under the green body. In this way, they escape from the predator. Now, adaptations in lion-tailed macaque. The lion-tailed macaque is also called the beard ape. It has a silvery white mane that surrounds the head from the cheeks down to the chin. Its tail is medium size, that of lions. It is a good climber and lives on trees. It feeds on fruit, seeds, young stems and flowers. It only comes down when it cannot find food. It also eats foods present under the bark of trees.
Thank you. Hope you have enjoyed the video and learned something from that. So till then, wait for the next video. Stay happy, stay safe. Bye-bye everyone.